Hey guys, this is my bike, the 2017 Africa Twin DCT. I've had this bike for nearly 3 years now. I've added a lot of parts and aftermarket accessories to this bike. I get a lot of questions on them. So in this video, I'm going to address all those questions. I'm going to tell you where I got the parts from, how they've helped me, would I recommend the part to you. I'll also tell you how much I paid for them, where I got them from. So yeah, keep watching. And sorry about the crow noises. That's how it is in Mumbai. Can, can all the time. So the first thing I did when I got the bike was get engine guards. These are GIVI engine guards, GIVI Upper and GIVI Lower. These are two separate serial numbers. This is the matte black, this is the oxidized. I would advise you to go for the oxidized, the silver, simply because it doesn't rest. Why did I say rest? I'll show you over here, this part is rusted. The C is very close by, so it's not surprising. So yeah, go for oxidized. You can buy either the upper or the lower. I got both. Now the reason I got GIVI is because in the middle of 2017 when I got the bike, most engine guard manufacturers for the Africa Twin were only giving me protection till here. GIVI was the only one that was going till here, and that's why I chose GIVI. I'm very happy with the guards. I've dropped the bike many times, at least 5 or 6 times in the past 2.5 years. These have absorbed the impact. Nothing is damaged, everything's safe. They absorb the impact, they bend out of shape, and you can pull them back into shape. That's the good part. And also, if you're ordering the GIVI lower, make sure you order it for the DCT. There's a DCT and a manual for the lower engine guard, so make sure you order the DCT. These engine guards are necessary even for someone who's not going off-road. You know, if it's a tall bike, you're going to drop it, you're going to lose balance at a signal, or you know, sooner or later you're going to drop it. You need these guards. And if you're going off-road, please don't go off-road without engine guards. So the engine guards are the first thing that you should get. And I mount my GoPro here, so I get some nice footage as well. And yeah, I'm damn happy. I definitely recommend GIVI. I'll put the model numbers below. So next I got this. You can call it the bash plate or the sump guard. I don't know, whatever you want to call it. I got these from ACD Racing. I think they're a Spanish company. This is made in Spain. I'm quite happy with them. You've got great coverage. There are other bash plates that go up to here. But anyway, I found this was good for what I wanted. Maybe I'll move up to something higher if I got more confident off-road. But for now, these are good. So check out ACD Racing. I don't think this next part needs any introduction. It's pretty much an industry standard. Barkbusters, Australian brand, made in Australia. Outside, cosmetic plastic cover. Aluminium black backbone. Aluminium backbone. These have saved my levers. I've gotten home even I've dropped the bike. They'll save your knuckles, they'll save your levers. Get these for sure, because the ones that come with most adventure bikes, the stock factory ones, are rubbish. Even the ones on Africa Twin were rubbish. So yeah. And I like the red, it matches my bike. You also have them in the white and black. And now in the blue, the new Africa Twin blue, you get a matching Barkbuster. Get that. Tyres. The Africa Twin came with Dunlop Trail Max 90-10 tyres. I didn't like them. Whoever I spoke to, no one liked them. I have no idea why Honda gave us those tyres. So I moved to these. These are the Karoo 3 50-50. But there's a funny story behind them. So I actually wanted a 70-30. 70% on-road, 30% off-road. So I saw the Karoo 3 by Metzeler. I'm a Metzeler fan. I've had Metzeler on my previous bikes. I'm devoted to Metzeler. So I wrote an email to Revzilla. I wrote an email to Fortnite and I said, these are the tyres I want to get. Are they 70-30? And they said, yeah, they're 70-30. So I ordered Karoo 3. But when they came in and I saw the groove, I saw the tread, I immediately knew, no, these are 50-50. So I got these by chance, by fluke, and I'm very happy with them. Like I said, I love Metzeler. Metzelers don't last long, you know, that's the only thing. But then they don't last long, that's the reason, you know, they're sticky, you know, I just love the grip on them. This is my second set in the front. I had Karoo 3 before. This is my second pair. And yes, I recommend Karoo 3 by Metzeler. So the first change I made was obviously Karoo 3 pair. I had Karoo 3 at the back as well. Now the Karoo 3, I told you, don't last long. So the rear wore out faster than the front. And on the rear, I moved to a Mitas EO 7 Plus. Why did I move to a Mitas EO 7 Plus? Because Mitas, well, great, I've heard a lot about them. They definitely last longer than the Metzeler Karoo 3. What did I find different about the Mitas? Off-road, both are equally good. The Mitas EO 7 and the Karoo 3 are great off-road rear tires. On-road, the Mitas EO 7 I felt are better than the Karoo 3. The Karoo 3, if I'm in the corner and if I brake in a corner, it would tend to break traction. The Mitas hold their line better than the Karoo 3. So this combination is working perfect for me now. The front Karoo 3 and the red Mitas EO 7, both are 50-50 tires, tubeless. I'm very happy with them. I think I'll stick to this combination for now, and I recommend the combination. So I said these are tubeless tires. Karoo 3 and Mitas EO 7 in the back are tubeless tires. Now you're going to ask me, but the Africa Twin has Tubetype, has a spoke wheel. How did you manage to get tubeless tires in it? So I installed an inner tape that comes by the name of Outex. Basically, you seal the rim inside so the air doesn't escape from the spokes. And I had it for over 2 years. I had no problem. So the key about the Outex is the installation. It has to be done correctly, slowly, precisely. Take your time, and it holds pressure is absolutely no problem. Now there are two things that I want to tell you about the Outex. There are people that say don't go Outex because the reason why Africa Twin gave us spoke wheels so we can reduce the PSI on the tire really low to go off-road. Yes, that is right. That's why they give you spokes, lower the air pressure. But even with my Outex, I've taken my air pressure to as low as 18 PSI, 20 PSI, and I've had no problem because the new age of dual sport tires have very thick sidewalls. They don't come off the rim so easily. So even if you go to 17, 18 PSI, I don't think this is going to come off the rim. But yes, if you're lowering PSI to 17, 16, 18, please don't go over rocky terrain too hard. Just go easy. These rocks will bend your rim and then you're screwed. Then you need a tube. So 2 years with the Outex, I developed, I noticed two spokes were leaking air. I had a flat tire, two spokes were leaking air. So it took out the entire rubber, the tire. And the Outex, the glue had dried up and it just came out in my hand like that. So I was left with no tape. I was back to a tube type wheel and I didn't know what to do. Then I did a search on a forum. And on a Ducati forum, I found a model of a number of a tape by 3M that does the same job. I got that. I'm going to put that tape number here. You can use that to seal the spokes. So you don't have to go for Outex. Outex is expensive. You can go for the 3M option. Like I said, installation is key. Do it slowly. Don't be in a hurry. Because if you don't do it right the first time, you're going to have to buy the tape again and start the process from step A. Mm. Have you tried this? It's damn good, man. Anyway, moving on, these are the stock footpegs that came with the bike. They're very narrow, everyone complains about them. Again, once again, I don't know why Africa Twin gave us these narrow footpegs. So I got wider footpegs. I'm going to show you a comparison. I got the wider footpegs from AliExpress. They're not pivot. I didn't get pivot simply because they weren't available in India. I'll probably get them when I go abroad or if we are traveling. For now, I'm quite happy with the wider ones, much wider than these. You should get them and try this. So I had the engine guards, I had the new tires, and now I just needed a decent luggage rack to head out for a long ride. These are by GIVI. I'm going to put in the model number. I got this from ebay.co.uk. These guards are doing really well. There's no rust on them. 2.5 years, no rust. Absolutely nothing has fallen off. Everything's there. So this also acts as a bit of protection for your exhaust, even if you drop the bike. So on these, I use rig gear. The rig gear soft saddle bags have a nice bright yellow and they have a black. I use those. So the combination is working perfectly for me. I think I have about 70 liters, 35 on each side. So this is the stock front fender, but I've raised it by almost 1.5, close to 2 inches. You get a front fender razor from ruggedroads.co.uk. I got that. They sent it to me. They do international delivery. It raises it by 1.5 to 2 inches. It's the maximum you can go without having to change the entire setup with the brake lines and everything. And the front fender kit. The front fender kit looks really good. It's really nice if you're going into muddy terrain where your front tire is caked up and stones can get stuck in the front mud guard. I don't need it now. Maybe I'll get it later. It's also expensive. It's over 200 pounds. But anyway, it's on my list. So there you go. That's my list of aftermarket parts for this bike. Like the video, like it right now. You see that subscribe button? Smash that subscribe button. It shouldn't be red, it should be black. Let me know if you have any questions, comments, type below or send me a message on Instagram and I'll reply. Thanks, and keep riding, keep enjoying.